This is an intro video about how to use a fletching jig. Maybe you've never used one before and just bought one, or maybe you're looking to buy one. I'm going to go over the steps involved with taking a raw shaft like this and applying fletchings to it, be they vanes, be they natural feathers. So when you buy a fletching jig, there's a lot of different types. Most resemble something like this. It'll have the base carrier, which is what the arrow sits into. That base supports some sort of indexing device. In this case, I have it set up for three fletch. That means that there are three positions that it locks into. The nock of the arrow fits into the indexing tool so that when you spin that, the entire arrow spins. At the top here, we have a little hook that supports the arrow shaft. What that allows you to do is align your fletching so that it's straight. As you can see, if you spin that up or down, it changes the angle slightly that the shaft sits at. If I rotate this around so you can see, you've got two knobs here. These knobs will allow you to take your clamp, which attaches on by magnet, and align it left and right. The clamps are different. There are three types. There's left, right, and straight. This is a left clamp. That means it's intended for use with left wing feathers coming off the left wing of the bird. The reason that that's important is on left wing feathers, you can see there's a little more lip from the feather on one side than the other. The side that has the lip should be twisted around the arrow like this, such that the side of the feather that would normally push down as the bird flies is what's pushing against the air as the arrow flies. If you fletch right wing feathers with a left wing clamp, it flies poorly. What will happen is initially the feathers will rotate the arrow in the direction of the clamp, but later on they'll rotate it based on the direction of the feather. You can try this with a flu-flu. It exaggerates the effect and shows it really well, but it doesn't fly well. So long story short, you gotta match up your clamps. All right, for arrow prep, I like to take a little sander block and sand the arrow down just a bit, just to knock a little bit of the finish off, which will create a bit of dust on the arrow. So I take a paper towel and some alcohol, and I'll wipe down the arrow shaft. And as you can see, you get a bunch of black dust coming off. Your arrow nocks will have a little groove on one side of them. You can feel it. That's your nock indexer. I like to set my arrows up so the nock indexer always points out away from the bow. That way I don't have to look at the arrow. I can just feel it and put it on correctly each time. So if you look at this clamp here now, you'll see that there are different tick marks that allows you to position each feather forward or back on the shaft to allow room for your fingers while you grip the arrow shaft. I like to use the large notch there because that allows enough room for my fingers. So I open my clamp, insert the feather, line it up. And as you can see right now, it sits poorly. What I want to do is I want to press it down on a hard, flat object like the table. I open the clamp just slightly as I do this. Now it sits flat and cleanly. From here, we're going to apply glue. When you apply glue, I like to start at the front end of the feather and run it towards the back. I find that I get a little bit more glue coming out at the start, and due to the position of the clamp like this, that glue runs down and evenly coats the feather as it dries. The type of glue I'm using is platinum fletch tight, platinum plus fletch tight. There's a lot of glues out there. I use this stuff because of the consistency. It doesn't dry the fastest, but it's easy to remove if I have to refletch an arrow, and the gel-like consistency makes it easier to apply. When I apply this glue, it comes with an applicator nozzle, and I just run a thin bead down the length of the quill. You want to make sure that you're not getting any glue on the clamp, or you glue the clamp to the arrow. If you're using a cyanoacrylate base glue, so a crazy glue or super glue, something like Goat Tough, you have a lot less dry time, but this gives you lots of dry time. You'll position your fletch clamp with your fletch and let the magnet grip it. And once you get it lined up, apply it evenly. And you want to give it a little bit of force, enough that you see glue bubble out along the shaft, but not so much that it slides off the shaft. From here, you'll let it dry for an amount of time that depends on your glue. For platinum plus Fletchlite, then they recommend a cure time of 5 minutes. Not sure if you can see that there, but trust me. I like to leave it a little bit longer because it sets better. On my second jig here, I've got another clamp that's already dry, so I'm going to take it off now. To do that, I want to squeeze the clamp and open it first before I remove it, otherwise I'll rip the fletch off. So I open it and remove it. As you can see, the fletch has come out and is glued on. I'll then take this shaft and I'll spin my indexer down at the bottom here to the next position and reapply. All right, so once you have your arrow out of the fletching jig, it's going to look like this. What you want to do to make your fletchings last longer is put a little daub of glue at the very end of each fletch. What this will do is prevent that fletch starting to lift up, especially if you shoot through a target like a stump or a hay bale. And then when you let it dry, you don't want to set it flat on a table, because that's going to bow these fletches out. You want to set it somewhere elevated so that the fletches are not in contact with anything. That'll give you the best overall product.